This is an experiment
in mind formation.
Information.
Forming.
Controlling.
Operating your mind
and your brain.
Using digital techniques.
To overload.
Scramble.
Confuse.
Unfocus.
Your mind. State of confused chaos. This is the state of the brain when it is ready to be informed, that is to be reprogrammed. The human brain contains 100 billion neurons. Each neuron is as powerful as a large computer. Around 10,000 connections with other neurons. Within our foreheads, there is a chaos. Inside our brains, there is a galaxy of information, which is incomprehensible to our linear minds. This contrasts and compares perfectly with the chaos without. We're living in a universe which has 100 billion galaxies. Each galaxy with star systems, planets, a complexity, again, which to our minds right now is chaotic, incomprehensible. Sit back, flow, open your eyes, turn off your mind, unfocus, and let the waves of chaos roll over your brain. Float, drift, zoom, design, create, new order, your order, your style, from chaos. Chaos. Yeah.
life to know thyself. Think for yourself. Question authority. Think with your friends. Create new realities. Philosophy is a team sport. Philosophy is the ultimate aphrodisiac pleasure. Learning how to operate your brain. Learning how to operate your mind. Learning how to redesign chaos. The religious leaders and the political leaders want to give you orders to run your life, to determine how you think. The basic goal is to operate your own mind. Operate for yourself. Around 3,000 years ago, a group of human beings in Athens, Greece, developed a new philosophy. The basic religion of humanity is called humanism. Socrates said, the aim of human life is to know thyself. Create and design your own order in the chaos. Socrates did not give commandments. Socrates did not impose order. Socrates asked questions. He encouraged his friends to speculate, to design, to create, to interact your own versions of reality. Socrates said, the way to perform philosophy is in small groups, raising questions, learning from each other, changing your mind, growing together, thinking together. The religious leaders said, you can't say that, Socrates. The gods are in control. Who are you to say you have to say? How dare you think you can know? Gods determine. Sacrifice to the gods. Obey the gods. Socrates said, no. Look within. For that, he gave Socrates the hemlock because he dared tell people, think for yourself. Question authority. To think for yourself, you must learn how to reprogram, reform, inform your own brain. Do this, to take responsibility for your brain, it is necessary to question everything that you have been taught, to question authority, to learn, to take the brave step of taking responsibility for operating your brain, for designing, redesigning, reforming the chaos within. Throughout human history, as our species has faced the frightening, terrorizing fact that we do not know who we are or where we're going in this ocean of chaos, it has been the authorities, the political, the religious, the educational authorities who attempted to comfort us by giving us order, rule, regulations, forming in our minds their view of reality. To think for yourself, you must question authority, and learn how to put yourself in a state of vulnerable, open-mindedness, chaotic, confused vulnerability to inform yourself. Question authority. Then came Marsha McLuhan in the 1950s. McLuhan said, in the Socratic sense, the medium is the message. The words you use, the modes of communication you use, determine the realities you inhabit. Most of our lives, most of us live in realities determined by others, imprinted in our brains by education, by religion, by politics, by the authorities. McLuhan said, if you want to change your mind, change the medium, change the words you use, change the mode of communication. If you change the medium, change yourself, you change your society. In the 1960s, a new mode of communication developed, television. The kids growing up in the 1950s learned how to tune in, turn on, fine tune. Turn off, select, determine what hits your eyeballs. You control your eyeballs and your eardrums. You direct and manage the media that program your brain. McLuhan said, who controls the media is programming your mind and programming your brain.
You watch a lot of television. Listen to this.
Audiographic overload, attempting to create a state of open-mindedness, pleasant vulnerability, in which we will inform and imprint the messages of the sponsor. Use your head, learn how to operate your brain. Your brain, you must understand how to use your eyes. Oh, say, can you see? Oh, say, can't you see what's being done to your eyes? Who controls your eyeballs controls your mind, imprints your brain. Oh, say, can't you see that the messages that hit your eyeballs in modern television are creating realities, imprinting messages from the sponsors who are not usually interested and you're learning how to design your own realities. Warning. Who controls your screens? Controls, programs your mind. Your eyes are the windows of your brain. The eyes are extensions of your brain. The eyes are made up of hundreds of layers of neurons, rods, and cones. Your eyeballs deal with one energy. It's light. Through your eyes come illumination, vision, perception, enlightenment, illumination. Your eyes are the windows of your soul. Who controls your eyeballs? Programs your brain. Learn how to dial, fine-tune your eyeballs. Learn how to unfocus your eyes. Dilate your pupils. Learn how to open up to illumination and light. And then refocus and redesign your own linear order, your own designs, your own language. To the pupil. Also passing on in this demonstration the message of Ralph Waldo Emerson, the first and probably the greatest American philosopher, who said, divinity lies within. Don't look to the churches or to the big marble institutions. Your divinity lies within. You must learn to operate your brain, operate your soul, learn how to communicate brain to brain, soul to soul, with other people. Your divinity lies within. nine realities. If you operate your own brain skillfully, you can learn to design your own realities, learn how to communicate in the language of the brain, electrons and photons. We are doing this now. We're sending messages from our brains using the vehicle of electrons and photons to your eyeballs. As we watch this screen, our minds are bedazzled, our minds are softened, our linear, sharp, logical thinking is gentle, and we're communicating brain to brain. We're using the electron, computer circuits, to feed each other's brains with light. This is the first paragraph, the first attempt, the first child's primer in how to communicate using both the orderly left brain and the chaotic, confusing language of photons and electrons. The brain is a photo board. Your brain and my brain, our brains, live on light, just as the body needs air and carbohydrates. Our brains are starved for light, for illumination, for revelation. Use your head, learn how to operate your brain. The brain is designed to design realities. He told us that the aim of evolution is for us to use media to create what we all want, the global village, the language which can be understood by every human being, by every brain, the basic language of humanity, the language of the brain, lights, sound, rhythms, pulsating your bones, moving your body. We all know this language. We can all sing and dance this language of electrons, of radio waves, of rhythms. Now we have digital communication. We can create our fantasies. We can create our rhythms. Design on screens. A new language will develop. A global language. Not based on letters. Not based on grammars. A language which we all understand. Based on clusters of waves. Of light. Sound. We all understand. We all celebrate. We all glory in the light, the illumination, the contact, the intersection, the interaction around the world, the language of form. We will create a language of international, global brain link-up. Anyone in any culture watching this screen will get the general picture. It's one global village. It's one global human spirit, one global human race. As we link up through screens, linked by electrons and photons, we will create for the first time a global humanity, not separated by words or minds or nationalities or religious biases. Now, listen to the message from the sponsor. There is one global human race. We're just now learning to communicate brain to brain, soul to soul.